Okay. Okay, it's giving me a right blinker, and that's not the way I want to go. I'm going to report that. Gave me a right blinker for a while there, so it's a little confused about directions. Okay, actually, I'm looking at my nav and it's totally off. The GPS is totally off, so I'm gonna disengage here and start over. I'll just drive manually because I don't know what it's gonna do. It thinks we're in another part of town. So I'm gonna report that. Nice car here. So let me engage this. The Genesis. Oh. Nice looking car. My GPS appears to be pretty messed up. It's showing me in another part of. It was showing me in another part of town, and that was confusing the nav route. It looks okay now. Slow down to let that, and in fact, I'm gonna disengage right now. FSD did not acknowledge the blinker on the car next to me that wanted to merge into my lane. So that's good. When it signals or when it changes lanes like that, if it's going between cars, it speeds up. That's really good behavior. Felt good. Thank you. Okay, that was good. Perfect lane change in front of that van. There was room, and I would have done the same thing, and it didn't brake or accelerate. Plenty of space, and the van had time to allow us in, and he did. So, cool. Okay, so it's slowing up to change into out of the off-ramp lane, or on-ramp, off-ramp lane. So again, we're using our settings, our autopilot. Average minimal lane changes is off. It seems to do a pretty good job at changing lanes, which is new. The last version, I didn't use it that much, but I didn't really have confidence in it, so I kind of think they've done a lot of work on this. Plus the speed profiles and the turning profiles are way better than the previous version. So there's a lot more comfort, it's a lot smoother. So I have my blinker on already here, and it doesn't yet. I'm gonna try it. Okay, we got the blinker on. Good. That's cool. I tapped the throttle just a little bit there, just to be sure it didn't slow down. So we have, the cars are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I tapped it there because the traffic is going there. Okay. So this is about the last second I was going to give it to start making lane changes, because we got to get over there pretty quick, and there's been plenty of opportunity, and I don't like just sitting here waiting, so let's let it speed up and make its move now. Okay. So it's waiting. There's nobody behind me. Boy, I don't like that twitching. Let's see, it should go now. Oh. And I'm gonna go. There's somebody behind me, so. It had an opportunity to go there. Too long at the intersection. So it slowed down there to get behind this car, which was the right move. And now
I will take off.
Minimal lane changes, and it starts changing lanes right away. Cool. Swerving there in the lane. Let's try this again. Not sure why it started changing the lanes. I guess it didn't realize it could go in front of that truck. So let's start it again here and see what happens. Exit. It would get in the lane there and just not get in the exit lane and just keep going down the freeway if I let it. So poor lane choice. Unnecessary hesitation for a vehicle turning right into the lane. Wrong lane choice. Nice saguaro. They've been selling them. $100 a foot installed. Okay, so that was perfect. Changing lanes into the wrong lane